Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and Android released the January 2020 security update that brings along with it some fixes and also some of the updates that you should have received if you didn't receive this in December. Now, this is available for the Pixel all the way down to the Essential phone, usually on the same day. If you have a Samsung device, it's going to take probably a few weeks for Samsung to actually push this update, but it could be sooner or later, depending on when they decide to do that. Other devices, it's up to the manufacturer. Now, this came in at a pretty small 21.4 megabytes on my Pixel 4 XL. And so this update installed pretty quickly, and it brings with it some security fixes and some UI fixes and things like that. So let's go over all of those. Now, also keep in mind that Pixel 1 is no longer supported. So the first Pixel and the Pixel XL are just not supported by Google anymore, unfortunately. So you won't get updates. But if you have one of the newer devices all the way back to the 2, you'll get support for this. And the first thing they fixed is notifications in the UI. So there was a fix for notifications displaying in the UI. That's been fixed on the Pixel 2 all the way to the Pixel 4, including all the XL variants. They've also fixed the NGA/flashlight toggle function. So if you were having issues with your flashlight here, turning on and off, that should now be resolved. Now that flashlight toggle fix was only for the Pixel 4 and 4XL. And then they've also fixed devices that were stuck during boot. So if you had an issue with that, with the Pixel 2 through the 4 and the XL variants, that will be fixed. Now, if you have a Pixel 2 or 2XL, they've also fixed issues if you are having Wi-Fi connectivity issues. So with your Wi-Fi, that should now be resolved. Also, with call speaker audio quality, they've improved that with the Pixel 3 and 3XL. So this update has a lot of little weird updates specific to different versions of phones. Now, if you have a Pixel 3A and 3A XL, they've also fixed issues with improvements in audio for video capture. So if you're using it for video within the camera, it should now fix the audio if you were having issues with that. They've also fixed an issue on the 4 and 4XL with color shifting at lower brightnesses. So if you have the display down very low, the colors could shift back and forth, and now that's been resolved. So we should have that fixed on all of these devices. Now, very good news for people that use WeChat. If you have a Pixel 4 or 4XL, it now supports the 90 Hertz display rate. So it should be much faster and smoother and work properly. So you should get all the benefits of that, plus be able to use WeChat without a problem. Now, for people that were using enterprise access points, if you have Wi-Fi and you are having issues with the Pixel 2 through the 4 and the XL variants, that should now be resolved. So if you are having that with enterprise-based access points. And then there's also various stability fixes, which they don't specify, but the device should just be more stable overall. So far, after using it for a day or so, it's been nice and stable, no issues. And battery has been pretty good as well. I'm at 62%. It hasn't charged overnight. I'm actually at CES, so it's a little bit different recording setup. And at CES, I don't plug it in all the time because I'm out and about. So it's actually doing pretty well. Now, there are various security patches as well, and I'll just run through these quickly. But there's three framework patches. There's media framework patches. There's system patches. There's also Google Play system update patches. And again, these are all for security. And then there's also kernel component patches, Qualcomm component patches, and then Qualcomm closed source security components that were patched as well. All of those things have been patched for the Pixel devices and anything that was supported, such as Essential and things like that. So you should be able to get this update. If you haven't gotten it already, you could sideload it. All of the different things are available to download through the Android developer site, or you can just wait for it and it should be rolling out to you. So shouldn't be an issue for you there. And then all of those Pixel feature drop issues, if you didn't get those yet, they may or may not be there. I don't have it for the camera with the adjustable depth after the fact, but it will be there eventually. So that's really it for this update. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And of course, I'll link this wallpaper as I always do in the description. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.
Like I said earlier, I'm at CES this week, so here's a view out of my room. It's an okay view, but most of the time you're at conferences and things like that. So if you see any other videos that look a little bit different, that's why.